right?
Okay, so this is our movie database. Okay.
Movie database. Okay.
Yeah, so whatever this site we have to build. Okay, so whatever I type here, suppose I type some movie it. Okay, so
okay.
And I click it, so it comes, right?
Okay,
okay. And so this, so see, so what is, so before building any site, right, suppose you have to build site like this. Okay,
okay.
So yeah. Just divide this site into different parts. Okay, so this okay. site will have two parts, right? This is search bar. Okay.
Oh yes.
And
yeah,
whatever you search, it will be displayed below. Okay,
okay. Yeah.
So this will, we have two sections. Like this is a search section, and this okay. is card. Okay, we name will name this as a card. This entire section. Okay.
Means this is such a section is a head bar, right? Head bar, heading.
Which?
This is movie DB and such a
yeah,
bar.
That, yeah.
Are
yeah.
in movie, are in header section, right?
Yeah, you can give it in header also. Like.
Okay.
Okay. So how you want to divide? You can divide it.
Okay. Okay, okay, yeah,
so, so now for we are dividing into two section. Okay,
okay.
This search section and this card section. Card section will have this entire card where my
okay.
arrow, where I am, okay, this arrow I am revolving, right? So
okay.
this is the card section, this is rectangle section. Okay, and this is a search section. Oh,
okay.
And whatever I type in the search and I select it, this is updated. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So we'll start. Okay. So as you see, we have always the main component, right? App component. Okay. So this is the app component. Our app will be loaded here. Okay. This is only how we do, right?
Yes.
This is the app we load. Okay. And we attach this app to a container. And what is this container? App. Okay,
app.
And this container will be in the HTML.
Okay.
Okay. So this will be again an empty div with ID app. See, this is the empty div with ID app. Okay.
Okay.
So yeah. This is our HTML. Okay. This is our HTML page. So in this HTML page, we have we'll put all our middle content in this app. Okay.
Okay.
And this way, and below that app will be footer. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, because this is footer, right?
Yeah.
This is the footer below thing.
Yes.
Yeah, this is the footer, right? So below it will be footer. In middle, it will be like in middle, it will be all our content. This will be our content. Okay, and this will be our content. Okay.
Okay.
This movie's title. Okay. So
okay.
Now we have so. The main will be loaded. This app will be loaded first. Okay.
Yeah.
This app is in this app.main component. Okay?
Okay.
So when I go to app.main component, we'll be having two things, search bar and card. Okay.
Yes.
Search
yeah.
box. So search box will is this is the search box, and below this is the card. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Now. Okay. Now when the when app is loaded here, this app, this component will get executed. This component is in app.main, so app.main.js will get executed. Now in app.main, this render method will get executed, and render method will return this HTML. Okay, and this HTML will have search and card. Okay,
card. Okay.
So now the control will go to this search box. So
okay.
Go to this search. This is a search box. Okay. Search
okay.
box component. Okay. So search box component. Search box component. This is the search. This is the input field, right? Because search
yes.
we this is the input box, right?
Just yes.
And the styling. So in this search bar. Okay, so in this search bar, we have given this type is text, ID we have given, placeholder we have given search movie title. That's
okay.
why this search movie title is coming here. Okay.
Okay.
So now whatever we search it, suppose it, I typed it. Okay. So
yeah.
what it will do when I type it, it will It will just yeah. So when I type, as I have see, I have mentioned movie ID here, right?
Yes.
Movie ID. So initially, when I hit the site, some movie should get display, right? So
yes. Yeah.
Suppose I am initially hitting this site, so this should get display, right? Or okay. I will not pass that movie ID, then it will be blank, right?
Okay.
But yeah. Should not be blank to the user. Something should be displayed, right? So yes. That's why I hard coded this movie ID. So this movie, this movie ID will be in the database. Okay. Movie will be mapped to this movie ID in the database.
Okay.
Okay. So this movie ID I have hard coded. So Interstellar will be displayed first. Okay. Now. Okay. What will happen? This is the this function we have binded, right, to this search
yes.
box. Okay.
Yeah.
So when I click on that, when I enter the movie and click on that search box, this will get executed. Okay. Fetch movie ID and movie ID. This movie ID we have hard coded it, right? Up 15 something. So this is the API. Okay. So this is the API it will hit with the movie ID and it will get the details for that movie ID. Okay. So the details will be available here. Okay. And now with that details, we are updating updating our state. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So if you see here, if I inspect it in network tab, suppose I type it okay, so see this AJAX call is made.
Okay,
so this will give the result. Okay, so this result will give. Okay, so this result, this result will give overview, title. A title is it. Okay, then popularity, like whatever the things we want to display. So see here, what is there? Date of release it will give, running time it will give, what is the average vote, box office collection. Okay,
okay.
So this all will be given by this API. So.
Okay.
Few types if you type it, then this request is okay. So this is requested. Okay, so this is the API. Okay, so this URL is API the movie org 3 movie 346. Okay, so this API we have mentioned here in app.js we have mentioned this API here. If you see this API the movie org 3 movie, okay, just we are dynamically updating this movie ID.
Okay.
So we are just passing the movie ID and whatever the movie ID is there, API will give all the details. So here all the details are given, like is it adult or not, what is the budget, okay, what is the home page, I am like this, it is given. Okay, what is the popularity, and this all details where we'll get will okay, we use fetch function, right? Fetch function to do AJAX call. Okay.
Yes.
And this is the URL we have formed. Okay. And the response will be available here. Okay. And this state will be updated. So we are updating the state. Movie ID.
Yeah, state is for updation. Okay.
Everything we will update. Okay.
Okay.
And to card, and this is the card component. Okay.
Yeah.
So card component will always display the details, right? Movie name. Okay. Then movie description, type of movie. Okay. So, whatever things we have will be having in this state, right? This state will be having all the things, right? What is the runtime, vote, release, but this needs to be displayed in card, right?
Yeah.
So we'll be passing state to the card. Okay, then only card will get all these values, right?
Okay.
Okay, so now when we pass the state to the card, then this is the card. Okay. This is the card. Okay, this HTML will get executed. Okay.
Okay.
So this HTML will have original release, runtime, box office, vote. Okay, and accordingly data dot release like this what we have sent right from there. So what we have done, what this dot props dot data. Okay, so if you see in the app.js, we have sent this
statement
to this data. Okay, so this is a prop, this is a property. Okay, so now we are doing here in card, we are doing like fetching this property, this dot props dot data. So whatever I have passed from there, it will be stored here. Okay, and this and this now everything is in this data, right? So what I am doing is I am just doing data dot release, data dot runtime. Okay, like this. Okay, so if you see here, you will be having release and the value, runtime and the value, total votes. Okay, like this. Okay, and all this, see, this is total revenue. Okay, so total revenue, these are all calculated here.
Okay,
see, this is total revenues, data dot revenue. Okay, so that's why. Okay, just they have stored in the variable, or else what you can do is directly you can write their data dot revenue. Okay, so that will also be fine. Just they have stored this in variable, that's why. Okay, because they need to do some calculation. Okay, so they have stored this in variable, or is directly you can write. Okay, and now see this all things, this is the div, okay, which is coming here. Okay, this thing is okay. Now on the left hand side, this is the poster. Okay, so if you see, this will be, this will come as a title. Okay, so okay, and this is and this will be the poster. Okay, this is the image. Okay, poster image. Okay, so this image URL will also come from the backend itself. Okay, so just you need to map it. So see, this is the this is the URL. Okay, so okay, so all the data will be available from the AJAX call. Just you need to pass to this card component, and you need to print it here. Okay, in the render method. Okay, so this everything, this all the HTML will display this middle section. This.
Okay.
Okay. So. Okay. So like this was the a small program. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So you got it. So like this you need to do.
And
you need to like in style also, right? You need to do
style. Yeah, any style. Also,
right? This is all styled, right? Properly arranged. So for styling, what they have done, this is the CSS they have used, like mma.css. So in this HTML itself, okay, they have loaded this CSS. Okay, see main.css. Okay.
Okay.
So they have loaded this main.css in the HTML itself. Okay. So you can do that also. You can directly, instead of loading in the component, you can load in the your HTML also. Okay. Okay. And any JS, extra JS, like if you want to use jQuery or anything, okay, you can load this in HTML. Okay, and use it in your React app. Okay, or else you can import it in mention in the package.json and import it in your React app. Okay.
Okay.
So this
what
is
about this script tag?
Which script tag?
Body after body. Down.
This one?
No, something like I seen script tag.
Okay, yeah, this is
Google Analytics.
Yeah, jQuery. Okay, so if they want to use jQuery, they have used this jQuery, and this is the Google Analytics. Okay, so this is not for, this is not used this is for tracking purpose, like for Google Analytics plugin. It is like for SEO, like search engine optimization, like whenever anyone searches your website in Google, it should come on first.
Okay.
Like, in, if you search anything, right, for, there are in Google, it comes like first this link, second, third, fourth.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Yes. So what this is like, if in Google, if you search,
yeah,
it movie. Okay. So this is coming first, right? So like that. Like that, if you do this Google Analytics, so it will accordingly, it will like, it will always be on the first, second, third. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
For that, they have used this Google Analytics plugin.
Okay.
So you don't have to use this, just okay. And yeah. And okay, so in okay, so like that, you understood this?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay, and this Bootstrap they have used. Okay, call you, if you study Bootstrap, then it will be good.
Right. Yeah.
Okay, so you understood this example?
Yeah, I understood this example.
Okay. So now we'll proceed further. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Now the second thing you wanted was
higher order components.
Yeah, higher order components. Okay. 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 So you wanted hooks, right? Hooks.
Yeah. When to use hooks? Why we are using hooks?
Yeah. Right? So see. So previously there were two types. We can write React in two types. Okay.
Okay.
So the first type. Just. Okay, so the first type was the first type was function based, and after ECMAScript 6 the second type came is class based. Okay.
Okay.
So yeah. What is the difference? There is no big difference. Like function in class based, how we can update the state of a variable, right? In class state we update the state, right?
Yeah, yes.
So in function based, we don't have that.
We don't have.
Okay. So in function based, we cannot update the state. Okay. But
okay.
After React 16.8 release. Okay. Or in React 16.8 release, now we can update the state in function based also. Okay.
Oh.
So so what they have done is. They have provided you so what use state hook. Okay, so this is called as hook. Okay, so they have provided use state hook. So you need to import this use state hook, and suppose this is the count, and so this is the variable, and this is the method for that variable. Okay,
okay.
So if you want to update that variable, then you have to call its method which you have mentioned here. So set count, count plus one. So like this, it will update it.
Okay.
Okay. So this use state you have to initialize. So they are initializing this use state to zero. Okay.
Okay.
And this is the variable. Okay. So
okay.
In class based, we'll be having the variables, right? We'll be having
yes.
the value pairs. So for yeah. each value, each key, we will update the value, right? By
yes.
using set state method. But in okay. this set state method is not there. So
okay.
we need to define some method for each
okay.
variable. Okay, suppose there
then we are using set count. Okay.
Yeah, here we are using set count.
Okay.
Okay. So while updating.
In class based, we are using set state, right? Here we
yeah.
are using set count.
Yeah. No, you can use anything. You can give this name any. You can give any name.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. okay. So this is the variable counts. That's why I've given set count. Suppose
okay.
the variable name was name, then I will give set name. Okay.
Okay.
So this
yeah.
is the variable, and this is the method for that variable. Okay.
okay.
So like that. Okay. So this is okay. So this is the hooks. This is the hook we used. Okay.
Okay.
So it can only be used in React version 16.8.
16.8. Okay.
Okay. Now we'll go to server side rendering. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so servers, so what we do is client side rendering, right? So whatever the HTML is, we load on the browser. Okay. But in the server side, the entire HTML is comes from the server. Okay, it doesn't load all the processing doesn't takes place at the client side. Okay, so all the processing will take place on the server side itself.
Okay,
so that's why server side, so that's why we are telling this as server side rendering. Okay,
means what data all will come from server only, right?
Yeah, from server. Entire HTML will come from server. Okay, it won't come from it won't be rendered on the browser. Okay, like from server it will come. Okay. So this is all. I will show you this example program. So like this is the package.json. This dependencies, dev dependencies, we need to include, and React DOM we need to include, and this extra we are Express.js we are using. Okay, for this.
Okay.
For this example. So this is the app, right? This is the app. So this is function based component. Okay.
Okay.
And this app we have loaded here. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, we have imported it and loaded it in the index.js. Now, now what they are doing is, see, this is the client. Okay. And this is the server. So now what we do is, on the client side itself, we render the HTML. Okay. But from server side rendering, the HTML comes from server. See how it is coming. Okay.
Okay.
So client is requesting the server, and server is giving the HTML. Okay.
Okay.
Index.html. Index.html means this one, this thing.
Okay.
Okay. In our program, is this index.html. Okay. So our index.html will always contain an app, right? Attached to this container. Okay. So it will load that app.
Okay.
So now if you see, this is the server.js. Okay. So this you need to make it. Okay. So in this,
we should make a client.js and server.js, two types.
No, server.js you have to make it. Okay.
Okay.
Server.js will have express.js. Okay. And why express.js is used? Express.js is used to make this type of RESTful APIs. Okay, so this is the RESTful API which server express.js is used to make this. Okay, so what it tells is, when the path is this slash, then render this app. Okay, so and the port is 3000 at 3000 port. Okay, so suppose see what we do is, this is 8080 port, right?
Yes.
So what they are telling, this is make this as 3000. Okay. And when it is slash, then render this app. Then render this component. This will come from server itself.
Okay.
So that's why. So for this code, we use Express.js. Okay, for server side rendering.
Okay.
Everything is same. Okay.
Okay.
Just the extra thing is this server.js. We are creating this server. Okay. We are creating the server and accessing the server at 3000 port. Okay. And at that 3000 port, if the request has slash, then we are rendering the app. Okay, so previously we didn't create it like this, right? Previously we didn't create it like this, but and if you see the webpack configuration, we will give server.js path to this.
Okay,
but in our example, what we used to give the path of index.js. Or main.js, here this index.js. So if it's client side, then we need to give path of this index.js. But if we are doing this server side, then we need to give path for this server.js. Okay, so if you know Express and Node, then only you will understand the entire thing. Okay, so the main difference is this server file only. Okay.
Okay.
So this server file is used to render.
In general, what is mean by Express? Just I need definition.
Express is used to create RESTful APIs.
RESTful APIs. Okay. Yeah.